Welcome to an absolutely gorgeous, cool, crisp day here in central London. Now, I arrived yesterday and I fully intended to do a review of the Point A Hotel Liverpool Street, which is just behind me. But then I completely and utterly cocked up. I arrived in the vicinity of the hotel and took some B-roll. I then did some establishing shots showing the hotel from afar. I even did a little bit of an introduction to the hotel and how it compared to other hotels.
So I would class these Point A hotels in the same category as a Premier Inn Hub or a Motel One. Bright, quirky, cheerful, but most of all, really reasonably priced for a London hotel.
And then finally I walked into reception to check in.
Oh, like that. Small hotels with a big heart. They've obscured the sign with that tree. Let's go inside.
And that's when I realised that it wasn't the hotel I was staying at. There's more than one Point A hotel near Liverpool Street here in London, and I arrived at the wrong one. My fault, I should have checked the address. It was a bit funny at the time because the receptionist had no clue what I was talking about. So this is the one that I was staying in. So today, in this video, I'm gonna do a quick review of the Point A hotel Liverpool Street, the correct one. Then we're gonna go and have breakfast in a local fabulous cafe here in London. Then we're going to head out to Stansted Airport and fly back to Edinburgh.
So let's have a look at the Point A Hotel Liverpool Street. Same bright, quirky, welcoming reception area. A lounge and bar area, and this is where you also have your breakfast. A hook for my hat. Big double bed, which actually takes up more or less the whole room. You've got to squeeze around the edges. Towels. Leather headboard with touch controls. TV, mirror, and what could almost pass as a desk and drawer space into the very small toilet and shower room. Very bright. Shower cubicle. Soap. And sink. There you have it.
Overall, I was really impressed with the Point A Hotel Liverpool Street. Small rooms, obviously, very, very comfortable with some quite nifty little gadgets. £92.50 is what I paid, but here's a tip. Join their frequent visitor program and you get 10% off all bookings. And you can also knock another 15 quid off if you have a room without a window. The hotel's actually located very near to Spitalfields Market. And that's partly why I got so confused. The original hotel that I went to is nearer Liverpool Street to the one that's called Liverpool Street. The Liverpool Street one is in Spitalfields Market. But there is that great big sign, Old Spitalfields Market. Magnificent old building, isn't it? Obligatory coffee van though. All those lights are pretty. Plenty of empty market stalls. I wonder whether these will fill up later. I love these old market buildings, given a modern twist. Back out onto the main road. Barber shop with a fabulous name, look at that. Jack the Clipper. Today I'm looking for Nilly's cafe. One of the things I love about London is the contrast between old world and new. Fabulous skyscrapers. I can see the gherkin, I can see the can of ham, and I can see the Salesforce Tower. Ah, there it is, Nilly's cafe. a good old-fashioned London local calf. Well, that was fantastic. Nilly's Cafe, beautiful breakfast, and I chose to have some bubble and squeak instead of baked beans. Very, very tasty. On the Rog Vlog food score, I'll give that a recommended. So you're not going to travel all the way to London just to try Nilly's Cafe, but if you're in the area, you must give it a visit. Okay, let's head off to Liverpool Street Station. More views of the incredible London skyline. Do you know, I could spend all day wandering around looking at the skyscrapers here. But one of the downsides is there's so much building work still going on, so there's so many bangs and clatters. The doctor's TARDIS has shrunk. I've never seen one of these before. It's a police post, as opposed to a police box. When I get to Liverpool Street Station, I always lurk outside for a few moments to take another look at the fabulous London skyline. There you've got Tower 42. That was one of the original London skyscrapers. Moving round there, we've got the Salesforce Tower. And what a gorgeous day it is here in London. Well, let's go and catch a train to Stansted Airport. Always take a moment to admire the incredible architecture in these London stations. They've recently purchased some new trains for the Stansted Express service, and these are really long, at least 12 carriages. But I always walk all the way to the end because the carriages are always emptier right at the other end. Yeah, this is more like it. So you see, at this end of the train, it's absolutely deserted, hardly anybody else inside this carriage. Let's have a quick look at the seats. They don't look too bad. Now, you know I have a problem with modern trains in the UK. Great sleek outsides, they look really space age, really modern, and inside, really uncomfortable seats. Well, these ones don't look too bad. There's even a bit of leather. Usual moquette. Quite bouncy. Perfectly comfortable for a 50-minute journey, and let's face it, it's a commuter train after all, isn't it? So we're not expecting luxury. Welcome to Stansted Airport. Now, you know how I always have a little moan about the forced route march through the shops at UK airports, and now I always have a bit of a laugh about, wouldn't it be great if you could buy a fast track pass through the shops? Well, here at Stansted Airport, the route march through the shops is so long and so arduous that they do allow you to buy fast track through the shops. It's called Fast Track Plus. The fast track pass means you go from here to here, or you've got the choice of going all the way round. But in the interests of science, let's walk all the way through and see how long it takes. And after all that walking, here we are finally at the gates. Walking at a really brisk clip, I managed to walk all the way through the shops in 6.5 minutes. That's still quite a long way, isn't it? Probably not worth paying for a fast track through, though, do you think?
Time for a bit of plane spotting before the flight. Nice to see a 747 coming in to land. Jet 2 off to somewhere sunnier, perhaps. And here comes our EasyJet flight for today. What an incredible day it is today to fly. Look at those blue skies. Absolutely gorgeous. And our ride for today is this EasyJet Airbus A319. Snow below on the hills reminds us we're in midwinter. Oh, I need this coffee. Oh, look, and as we come towards Edinburgh, I can see my favourite place, Fisher O'Harbour, right down there. Fabulous. Welcome to Edinburgh Airport, and it's an absolutely glorious day here as well. Well done, EasyJet. Yet another bang-on-time flight. Do you know, I must be approaching 100 flights with EasyJet in a row without any delays. They are absolutely my favourite short-haul airline. You know, given that cock-up with the hotels yesterday, I was extra careful today to make sure I didn't get on a plane to Glasgow or Prague or something. What an amazing day to be back here in Edinburgh. Thank you for coming along with me on this rather random trip to London. I had a great time. And tell me, what's your favourite budget hotel chain? And if you've got any suggestions for some local cafes in London to rival Nilly's Cafe, do please let me know down below in the comments. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Rog Vlog. Until the next video, remember, there's always something to see. So get out there and find it.